the oceans act as the lungs for the body that is our Earth. Without the global ocean, we would cease to exist. An important phenomenon that has balanced natural and anthropogenic carbon dioxide emissions is oceanic sequestration, which is today's topic. Oceanic sequestration is when the ocean traps and stores carbon. We call this blue carbon. According to UC San Diego's Scripps Institute of Oceanography, 26% of all carbon dioxide released every year between the years 2002-2011 was absorbed by the global ocean. During this 10-year period, the average annual total release of carbon was 9.3 billion tons per year, with 2.5 billion tons going into the ocean. If our carbon footprint continues to increase, the oceans will not be able to keep up. Our large outputs of carbon are already having devastating impacts on the ocean through the forms of coral bleaching, rising sea levels, and increased ocean acidification. One way that carbon is sequestered by the ocean is through coastline plants such as mangroves, seagrasses, and tidal marshes. The global ocean's coastline is actually long enough to wrap around the planet 15 times. These plants can even sequester 2 to 35 times more carbon than phytoplankton. Unfortunately, due to anthropogenic activities, many of these plants and their habitats are being destroyed, ultimately reducing their sequestering abilities. Furthermore, the large populations of phytoplankton in the global ocean can help sequester carbon through the process of photosynthesis. With increased nutrients from agricultural runoff, phytoplankton colonies can thrive and sequester more carbon. The global ocean is actually one of the largest carbon sinks we have. Through a process called vertical deep mixing, when currents are carried from low to high latitudes, they cool and become heavy enough to sink below the surface. The cooling of the water allows it to dissolve atmospheric CO2 and take it below the surface. However, this process is what causes ocean acidification, because when CO2 is absorbed by seawater, chemical reactions occur that reduce the pH of the seawater and carbonate ion concentrations. The oceans are the life system of our planet, and it is vital that we treat them as such. Thank you.